As a chef who grew up in Toronto, being one of the hosts of this series for Food & Drink magazine is a dream assignment for me. I get to hit the road and check out the culinary scene in different areas of Ontario. And I get to do it all with a different guest each episode. Today is going to be a great day heading out to the Niagara region about 90 minutes outside of Toronto. And I'm going to be picking up an amazing Niagara chef. She's a local. Her name is Tanya Ganassini. She is a plant-based chef. She's an entrepreneur. And we're going to be hitting up 5 stops in the Niagara region. We're going to be looking to draw inspiration and pick up some amazing artisanal ingredients, incredible food and drink that are there. And at the end of the day, we're going to put together an incredible dinner. I can't wait to get started. I'm meeting Tanya at her local, and our first stop, the pie plate. This looks incredible. It smells so good in here.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
I love this place. So much. This is one of my favorite spots in the region.
This is the spot.
This is the spot.
Okay.
This is the pie plate.
Yep.
And this is Maddie.
Devan, nice to meet you.
She's a good friend of mine and her family owns this place.
Yeah.
Amazing.
We source everything locally here in Niagara. We use only local farmers, local fruit.
It all looks so incredible.
I know.
It looks so artisan and just so delicious. I want it all. What do we have to have here?
Well, right now it's peach season. Peach pie, peach scones.
I saw your eyes.
I definitely want peach scones.
Yeah. For breakfast, peach scones.
And you, what are you gonna get?
You know, I think we need some baguettes for dinner.
Sure.
And then definitely a peach pie.
And peach blueberry pie?
Yeah.
We want everything.
Okay. We're here at the perfect time of year where everything amazing is in season. You have blueberries, peaches, apricots, plums, like every stone fruit, tons of beautiful summer vegetables. And we're gonna cook with a lot of those ingredients tonight.
Yeah.
I love this area so much, and I'm really excited to show it to you because there's something fun kind of discovering a place for the first time. It's truly endlessly inspiring. Like, this is the place to be if you're a chef.
I'm excited for this trip. I want to experience everything that Niagara has to offer. So where are we going?
So we're going to Rosewood Winery.
Okay.
Actually, the only stop today that I have never been to.
Oh, that's exciting.
I'm really excited. All of the other stops I love and I can evangelize about them. So I'm really excited. Have you been?
Never been before. I've been to Niagara on the Lake, but I've never been to Rosewood. I also don't know what evangelize means.
Me neither. Wow,
it's
super beautiful.
Was to build a family winery meadery. And honeybees for us are fundamental and paramount to everything we do here at Rosewood. Honeybee is omnipresent.
Are you afraid of bees?
No. Are you?
No, not at all.
Wow.
This is where the queen has been laying some of her eggs.
Wanna go for it?
Yeah, I kind of do, actually. Yeah, there's something really calming about this.
All this honey talk. Can we try some of this?
Definitely.
Okay, I'm going in.
So this is a really nice wildflower base blend.
It's so good.
Wow. So the smoked honey is really unique.
I feel like this is up your alley.
I'm a big fan of smoke.
Wow.
This is like the most fun dessert I've had in a while.
It's kind of like butter, right?
So we're getting to the good part. We're going to taste some wine. Wow, I love that.
So this is our Mead Royale. So the Mead Royale is our honey wine, basically.
Wow.
So we're taking honey, we're adding water, we're diluting them together, and then we're allowing these to begin fermentation in tank.
Sorry, we need a moment of silence for this. This is incredible. This is next level. You can taste the terroir, you can taste the honey, but it's not adulterated at all. You guys approach winemaking like how really great chefs approach food. You're sort of letting nature speak for itself. I feel like I have a new appreciation for this region and what you guys do. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But where are we going now? Because we're going to our third stop.
So are you a big cheese guy?
I'm a huge cheese guy.
We're going to Upper Canada Cheese. They do some really, really unique cheeses. We're here. We're gonna taste some cheese. Is that a cow?
Is that a cow?
Oh my God, that's a cow.
It's not an ordinary cow. This is a Guernsey cow.
Guernsey cow. So is this cow ideal for producing a specific type of cheese? Or
yes. All our cheese is made with Guernsey milk. It's high in milk fat. It has lots of beta carotene, and you'll see in some of our cheeses the wonderful coloration it gets from the beta carotene, and it's just a superior milk.
So who is this beautiful animal?
Yeah. This is Jedi.
Jedi.
She's so beautiful.
She's visiting us from the comfort farm.
We milk about 45.
45. The farm is about 20 minutes away from
okay.
here, so the milk's fresh every time we make cheese.
I think it's time we sample some cheese.
Yeah? Are you
all
ready?
This talk.
Thank you for your hard work, Jedi.
She's the star of the show.
This is our signature cheese, Niagara Gold. There you go.
Thank
Ladies
you.
Ladies first.
Yes. Salute.
Salute. That with the honey.
That'd be amazing.
Oh. All right, comfort cream.
That's my favorite.
I'm going to grill our Guernsey girl.
That's the jam. That's the one.
We're gonna have a really good time cooking with these.
For sure.
Thank you.
Another inspiring adventure. But now we're going to our fourth stop. We're going to Quiet Acres.
I go there at least twice a week. It's one of my favorite farm stands in the region, and they just have a wide variety of really, really high quality produce.
Let's go check it out.
All right. I can't wait.
These plums look amazing. Wow.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
You know, you never see fresh dug potatoes like this.
So everything that we sell is all picked fresh every day. Yeah, so we only sell what we grow, so it's all from our farm.
I love what you guys do.
Yeah. It takes many hands. It's a labor of love, that's for sure.
So we're gonna grab some red skin and some Yukon.
Awesome.
I think we need some garlic.
A variety of garlic is called music.
Okay.
And it's a hardneck garlic, and it will last well into next April.
No way.
So, yeah.
I find this time of year really overwhelming because I wanna use every single thing.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing here?
Yeah, I would probably say the peaches. Thank you. And if you want to just take a stroll down the laneway,
yes.
You can help yourself. Enjoy.
Thank you. Oh, and thank you.
Okay.
Have a great
thank
day,
you.
Maureen.
You have a good day as well. Thank you.
Yeah, the nectarines are insane.
This is the best thing I've tried so far.
And now, ready to cook?
Yes.
We're heading to Oast House, which is one of my favorite breweries in the region.
Okay.
Might be a little biased.
Why?
Because, well, my husband is the chef there. but it's truly an amazing place. You're gonna love it. And it's the perfect place to complete our day.
And we get to finally cook with all the amazing stuff we gathered all day.
This is why we do what we do.
Let's do it.
So what are you making?
I'm making this apricot and tomato salsa with chili.
Okay.
Gonna hit that with some lime juice, salt, and pepper. And this is gonna go with one of our beautiful cheeses on a nice crostini.
Amazing.
And I'm gonna hit it with more chili because I'm a savage. What are you making?
I'm gonna make a smashed cucumber salad.
Okay.
And it's gonna have some charred garlic scapes in it.
Yeah.
Tomatoes.
Okay.
Crushed peanuts.
Yeah.
Black vinegar. Some shoyu,
what else you
like a sesame scallion kick in there.
This is rustic. Well, it's a freshness.
This dinner is so quintessentially Niagara. Eating food that was gathered locally from people who really care about what they do, and it's the perfect way to spend an evening.
Moments like this are the true epitome of summertime.
Cheers! Cheers!
This is why I love to cook. Cooking is nurturing people and bringing them together, and this is a true showcase of that. You know, I've spent a lot of time in Niagara in the past, but I've never experienced Niagara the way that I did today. To meet these artisanal craftsmen, just meeting them and learning their story was an incredible experience. We're sitting on picnic tables. We're overlooking a vineyard. This is how it's done in Niagara.
On the next episode of Five Stops, join me, Miranda Keys, as Chef Nick Liu and I check out Ontario's Garden, Norfolk County,